Having grown up in Newfoundland, I'm well acquainted with what it's like to be in a fog. On a foggy day, everything is a bit drab, and if the fog is thick enough, it's hard to see clearly or to have a sense of direction. This is what my faith was like growing up. I received my sacraments and on some level believed in God, but God for me was more like a far-off foreign concept or a school subject to study rather than a person to have a relationship with. I didn't attend Mass very often, and the rare prayer that I would say felt memorized and mechanical. I was a happy child from a loving family, but I didn't really have a sense of direction, purpose, or meaning to my life, and I met the world with a very flat, superficial outlook. I could liken it to a little girl playing in a mud puddle, who was so used to playing in that mud puddle that she never knew there was a vast ocean right around the corner waiting to be discovered. As a teenager, mostly out of a sense of obligation, I received the sacrament of confirmation. And in confirmation class, the teacher shared the importance of attending Mass every Sunday. So I began to attend Mass more regularly and was invited to join the church choir and the youth group. Even though I didn't really know what a youth group was, I decided to attend as some of my friends would be there, and I was promised free pizza. At youth group, I met other Catholics who actually had a desire to know and love God, and I could see that their faith was a priority in their lives. It was at a Christian youth conference that I attended with my youth group that my life was changed forever. During the conference, the speaker invited anyone who had never made a public, personal decision to invite Jesus into their heart to come forward, and there would be someone to pray with them and lead them in making this important decision. Hearing this invitation, I felt it was for me. My heart started racing, and I was drawn to go forward. As a woman led me in a commitment prayer and prayed for the Holy Spirit to come into my heart, I experienced an amazing peace, joy, and love unlike anything I had ever experienced before. I began to cry with joy. The tears lasted for hours. My mom came to pick me up and I was still crying. She was worried that something was wrong and asked what happened, and my friend who was with me said, "She's experienced the Lord." That night, God made himself known to me in a powerful way and made me aware of his presence in my life. He showed me he was real. He was who he said he was, that he loved me personally, and that he wanted to have a relationship with me. From that moment, the fog was lifted, and I had a new sense of purpose with a clear direction. I was given a new hunger to know God and a new excitement to grow in his love. I began to hear the voice of the Holy Spirit speaking in my heart, speaking through scripture, through music, through people, and through the everyday circumstances of my life. My life was no longer drab and superficial, but an exciting, fulfilling adventure with God. As I came to learn more about God and my faith and continued to experience the Holy Spirit in deeper ways through various groups, ministries, retreats, and conferences, I began to explore, discover, and play in the vast ocean of God's love that I never knew existed. I now knew the meaning of my life, to love God, to be loved by Him, and to share that love with everyone. It's not that my life was without suffering or that I didn't stray from his path at times, but I could finally have confidence to know that I was holding the hand of the one who made the universe, who created me, and who would guide me at every step through joy or trial, This initial spark of the Holy Spirit's love within me as a teen laid the foundation which, in the years following, developed into a new, unexpected adventure, my love story with the Lord in becoming a religious sister. The adventure continues now within my community as I seek to open my heart to God and to have Him rekindle that spark of the Holy Spirit in my heart every day through prayer. Scripture says, "The wind blows where it wills, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it's going." So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Is your life an adventure with God? I encourage you, whether it's for the first time or the 100th time, to open your heart to God and invite Him in a new and deeper way. Allow the love of the Holy Spirit to transform your life, to give you a new purpose and direction, and to take you on the greatest adventure.
Look up and lift your eyes. The future's open wide.
Thank you, Sister Rose Clare, for this story of your encounter with the Holy Spirit and the Jesus and the Lord. I want to bless you with the abundance of His heart within your own heart as He keeps transforming you and as you get closer to Him. I pray a blessing of the Holy Spirit with all the gifts that He wants to give you as the Lord has an unfailing love towards you. He has adopted you as His daughter, His precious daughter, created wonderfully. And He loves you dearly. So we just ask more of all the gifts to come within your heart, your mind and soul, transforming you more into His image. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
I set every star to place so you would remember my name. I made it all for you. You are my masterpiece. You are the reason I see. This is my song for you. Every star.